The iPhone, a cheap trinket. The Samsung S3, the phone of the commoner. And Samsung battles Apple in a U.S. courtroom over the right to hawk its handsets to the masses. Those who'd rather not be seen with the same mobile as the 99% are looking elsewhere. Like this posh art gallery in London, where Vertu announced a limited edition charity run of its Constellation phone this summer. With a starting price tag of $6,000, it's about 10 times more expensive than the latest iPhone. So why do mobiles like these command such a premium? Well, depending on how much you fork over, your handcrafted phone comes with gold trimmings, diamonds, even crocodile skin, and a 24-hour concierge. But where these phones don't stand out is features. Vertu's top-end handsets all rely on Symbian OS. That's a 1990s-era operating system it inherited from Nokia before it was sold off to private equity firm EQT in June. You can also forget the inconvenience of buying and updating your apps because there aren't any available. French firm Atelier, which designs handsets for luxury brands like Tag, Dior, and Versace, is trying to change that. Their latest phone, the $3,600 Tag Racer, is powered by Google's Android operating system.
Before, when we think about luxury phone, we think about basic features, very standard phone, very nice, but nothing really inside in terms of technology. And now, with this new generation of products, we will attract new customers who are really demanding to have high technology, combining with luxury design and luxury material.
Vertu owner EQT declined to comment on the operating system for its next generation handsets. Leaked photos, though, on a Chinese tech forum suggest an upgrade is in sight to the Windows 8 mobile platform. IDC stats on sales show strong growth for smartphone makers in the second quarter, including former Vertu parent Nokia. For the customers of these Uber phones, the decision to buy is less like a tech purchase and more like buying jewelry or an expensive watch. China has been in the driving seat of global luxury spending growth, and it's the top buyer of Tag's line of phones. But Bain & Co. warns the Chinese market will advance just 20% this year, down from 30% in 2011. That's in part because of new government restrictions on corporate-sponsored gift-giving of luxury items.
I expect corporate gift-giving will continue once things clear up and calm down, because it's still part of the Chinese culture.
With Europe mired in austerity and the U.S. recovery still uncertain, luxury phone makers are counting on Chinese demand to stay strong. That means adapting with the times and producing phones that aren't just physical works of art, but with software good enough to merit the price tag.
Even the spell's expensive.
Yes.
John Gordon in Hong Kong.